different terrestrial habitats in the Maltese Islands. The most common is garrig.
Garrig is an open rocky area with many holes in the ground, which one can find a thin layer of soil. Garrig plants are usually low-lying aromatic bushes. Shrubs like this are adapted to the summer heat and the lack of water. This is Mediterranean thyme. It is a small, aromatic herb, commonly found in rocky areas. The Maltese pyramidal orchid is endemic, so it can only be found in the Maltese Islands. Flowers of garrig shrubs are an important source of nectar, which is collected by bees to form honey. Mediterranean woodland is the most typical habitat of the entire Mediterranean region. In the past, before humans arrived on the island, Malta was covered with woodland. Over the years, the trees were cut down for building and to clear space for farming. Today, this habitat can only be found in a few places in Malta. Basket, the major part of which was planted by man, has now acquired the character of a semi-natural woodland. Here, the trees regenerate naturally. In Mediterranean woodlands, there are smaller shrubs growing underneath larger evergreen trees. Some of the most dominant trees in this area are the Aleppo pine, Arab tree, olive tree, and holm oak. Some trees are thought to be over 500 years old. The Aleppo pine has needle-like leaves. In the past, the species used to grow naturally in the wild, however, it was completely wiped out. Recently, there have been a number of afforestation schemes where this tree has been planted. The carob tree is also found in areas of woodland. Although the tree is evergreen, it sheds leaves all year round and makes the soil beneath it very fertile. Both the Aleppo pine and the carob tree are protected species in Malta and Europe.
Follow me.
Valleys are areas with steep sides. Most of these valleys were made in the past. Malta's climate was wetter and there were large rivers. Many species of plants grow on the valley sides, such as the Maltese spurge and rosemary. You can see how the plants live in the cracks on the valley side. Different species of plant grow on the valley floor, such as the carob and lentisk trees. The valley floor sometimes might become flooded when there is a lot of rain during winter. Here, you can see all the rocks that were transported by the rain.
Did you know that half of Malta is made up of fields?
Cultivated fields are used for growing crops or rearing animals during different times of the year. Many times, chemicals like pesticides and fertilizers are used to help grow crops. During the time these fields aren't being used, they become covered with flowers, like the yellow flowers of the wild turnip, and poppies with their red color. Although we've only seen 4 habitats, there are many more. This is even more impressive when we see how tiny the Maltese islands are. We need to protect and preserve all our habitats, their plants and animals.
Remember, geography is everywhere.